Hello, my crafty friends. Welcome to Gadag DIY. Hope you have noticed the changes in our channel and let me know if you like the new look. This is Deepta, the creator behind Gadag DIY. Going forward, I'm going to interact with you all so that we can make friends. This week's DIY is four kitchen organizers. I'm going to show you how I did these and the list of supplies I've used for this. Stay tuned. Let's create a crafty world together. For this organizer, I'm going to use an embroidery hoop. Since I ran out of the inner hoops, I'm using the outer ones and found an easy way to remove the nails and the clamps using a plier. Just remove them and then connect them using hot glue. Add multiple coats so that it stays secure. This is gypsum board. It is available in Plaster of Paris and the false ceiling shops. It's a quite sturdy material which gives a wood-like finish and also can be cut easily using a cutter blade. I've used dark brown acrylic paint to paint all of these. Link is in the description. I'm going to wrap this gypsum board with a plastic shelf liner. This will provide an oil-proof and waterproof finish. This is generally available in the kitchen organizing section of any shop. I've also given the product link for this in the description. Now comes the tricky part of fixing them on the embroidery hoop. You need to balance them appropriately. I'm also using these big beads and fixing it at the bottom so that it will not roll over. It's done. Currently, I'm using this as a cup holder in a corner of my kitchen. You can also use this as a tissue holder or a spice rack. Let me know if you like this idea. I've used WPC wood plastic composite sheet for this project. These are generally available in hardware and plywood shop. I've also found this in Amazon. I've given the link below in the description. These are very sturdy, very easy to cut, at the same time very inexpensive and gives a wood-like finish. I cut out 4 30 into 8 cm rectangles and now painting it with teal acrylic matte finish paint. As the finish of the WPC sheets are quite soft and glossy, we need a couple of coats of paint to get a proper finish. I have used these waterproof resin sheets. These are available in the upholstery shops. As we are going to use all these organizers in our kitchen, I've used waterproof and oilproof supplies so that it would have a durable lifetime. I've wrapped two of these WPC sheets with this resin cover. I got this drawer divider from Amazon. This has come out for a very inexpensive price. I'll give the link in the description below. If you are a regular visitor to our channel, do let me know if you like the new look and feel. I'm waiting to hear from you all. Using the WPC sheet and the plastic divider, I made two of these shelves. This organizer is pretty sturdy and is durable. It can be very well used in our kitchen for a longer time. It's done. I kept my spices in the shelf. It has really given a very nice look to my kitchen. In the coming weeks, I'm planning subscriber creation showcase videos and also more innovative decor ideas. So please do consider subscribing so that we can keep in touch. I've taken a 26 into 18 centimeters of cardboard and drawing a hook-like structure. Using a cutter blade, I'm cutting the edges off. To get a fine cut in the cardboard, you have to use a cutter blade. That's the trick behind it. Sticking two of these cardboard to make it look thick. We will need two of these blocks. I'm going to wrap these cardboard blocks with black chart paper. You can also use any cardstock paper. This will give a very nice and seamless finish. I'm going to use gypsum board for this project. As I have previously mentioned, they are very easy to cut and has a wood-like finish. If you want to know about these different dimensions, check the description section. I'm going to wrap these gypsum boards with these Rexin sheets. These are available in the upholstery shops. I'm painting all the gypsum boards with black acrylic paint. I have used Fevicryl brand, which is available in India, for this. Our channel has a variety of decor ideas to decorate your entire home. So do visit our channel to get a lot of inspirations. I have used these Rexin sheets in place of the regular color paper, as these are oil and waterproof and it will go well in our kitchen. It's done. In my kitchen, I'm using this to keep my oil cans. You can also use this as a cutlery stand or a tissue paper holder. Let me know if you like this idea in the comment section. Don't forget to give me a thumbs up. For this idea, I'm going to use the inner circle of an embroidery hoop. I'm going to show you how to knit this woolen thread around the circle. First, wrap around the bottom and bring it to the top. Now, go over the top of the hoop. Now, bring it to the center and pass it through the top of the center. Now, you have to repeat it at 1 cm distance around the circle. If this is the first time you are visiting our channel, do consider subscribing so that we can keep connecting. Now I have knit the entire circle and tying a knot to secure it properly. Recently, I am uploading a lot of kitchen decor ideas in our channel. Do check the other videos and let me know if you like it. Next, I'm going to use this one-sided cardboard. I've given the link for this in the description. Fixing a 5 cm width of one-sided cardboard around the circle. We would need two of these baskets. Painting them with silver acrylic paint. I've given the link in the description. Painted 4 wooden spatula with black paint. Now, fixing the spatulas around the circle. Let me know if you want me to try out any other decor ideas in the comment section. It's done. Let me know if you like this idea. I kept this in one corner of my kitchen for my readily accessible fruits and vegetables. Do give me a thumbs up, my dear friends. Let's create a crafty world together.